Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's another episode of Azure Friday, and I'm always thrilled to talk to Ziv Rafalovich because he's always here to save me money. And today we're going to talk about low priority scale sets in virtual machines. How are you?
Thank you. I'm happy to be here again, yeah. Scott. So yeah, today, low priority scale sets. And the big news is between 60 to 80% discount.
80%.
80%. Well, 60 for Windows and nearly 80, or actually a bit more than 80 on different VM sizes for Linux.
That's amazing. So yep. If I'm serious about saving money, I can find a compromise between getting my work done and saving serious bucks.
Yep, exactly. Go to the pricing calculator in Azure and see the actual price.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. So how does this work? This is the difference between paying for guaranteed SLAs and guaranteed virtual machines versus using that slack capacity.
Exactly. We have unutilized capacity in Azure. Buffers, capacity we just onboarded, but no one actually used yet. And we want to resell it. So we will give it to customers. We will sell it at mm-hmm. this discount in all regions, today still in public cloud, mm-hmm. all VM sizes, mm-hmm. With one exception, which is the B size. But imagine the biggest VMs, you can try for 80% discount.
All right. Okay. Yeah. So what's the catch?
There's always a but. Mm. Okay. So availability is not guaranteed.
Makes sense.
Capacity is not guaranteed.
Also makes sense.
We will not service heal you. So if something goes wrong, your VM will be failed or deallocated. We will give you one full domain, so don't plan for any high availability topologies. Mm-hmm. And instances will be evicted when a paying customer asks for the capacity.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yep.
That makes sense.
Now, when we need to kick you out, we call it eviction. It's a nicer word. And there are two policies you can pick. The first, which is the default, is to deallocate. We just stop the VM. You get your disk. It's still there. You're still paying for the disk, by the way. So if you have used the disk, it's a long boot time. You saved local state on the disk. You may be able to try and redeploy that VM. Mm-hmm. The second policy is delete. We'll just delete the VM, delete the underlying disks, and you won't pay for the disk. And the actual benefit for deletion is it works well with autoscaling. Hmm. So you can actually put VM scale set and then autoscaling, VM scale set autoscaling. So we will evict your VM on one end, but autoscaling will compensate for it on the other end.
And compensate by trying to find somewhere else for you to live.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
So somehow I'm imagining myself in a hotel where I'm sleeping in rooms that no one's paying for right now. So I get the slack space. You give me 30 seconds warning. I pack my bags. I get out of the hotel.
To the next room, maybe.
Paying customer doesn't know I was there, but right. I find another room.
Yeah. So you mentioned the notification. We are offering 30 seconds notification mm-hmm. using our in-VM scheduled events. So it's a local endpoint, non-routable mm-hmm. IP. You just make a simple REST call, and you'll get 30 seconds notification. You can save state or notify some job scheduler and so on and so forth.
Okay, so if I'm polling for that, if I write my software where I'm smart and my software is written such that I know I'm part of the low priority scale sets,
right?
I would just pull that local endpoint. I see that I've got 30 seconds, finish up what I'm doing, shut down, save my state somewhere else in Azure, maybe storage in a queue somewhere. It's up to me.
Notify a job scheduler of some sort. Yep.
Mm-hmm. And then get ready to pack my bags and leave.
Yep. So let's go to a demo.
Let's do it.
All right. We'll start with Cloud Shell, mm-hmm. and we'll use the CLI to create a low priority scale set.
Okay.
And it doesn't go simpler than that. You see, that's the simplest VM scale set creation.
Right.
I just added a priority low. Okay, I'm just going to copy it. And nothing new, same good old scale set, paste. And here goes nothing. And we're just going to provision a low priority scale set.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So you hit enter at this point.
Yep. It will take a couple of minutes. But in the meantime, I want to actually show you two other interesting use cases. So the first one is, as we mentioned, we combined the delete on eviction policy mm-hmm. with VM scale set autoscaling. Mm. So when Azure needs the capacity, my VM is being evicted, but then autoscale VM scale set will try and recreate another instance.
Okay, so this is finding another one that is still low priority.
Yes,
so
still low priority.
I'm being moved, but I'm still saving
Correct.
Money.
Correct, exactly. And let me just... So I have here...
There's some existing things you've made before.
Yes.
So there's a low priority one in the West Central.
Correct. That's a low priority scale set.
Okay.
And as you can see, actually, let me just
auto scaling is on there.
You can see looking back, This is evictions from last night. This is a template we actually published, and you can, it's a web farm of some sort, and you can start creating jobs to actually run those CPUs busy. And my autoscaling rule used CPU, average CPU,
right,
to scale up. Okay, so there is an autoscaling here. Set to 60% I bump up, and less than 30 I bump down, and range between 5 and 20. Again, all low priority VMs. Mm. Okay, if I look at my instances, I've been running this for quite some time. Now I'm currently in my instance 183. So every here and then, Azure will evict my VM. Then if there is a load or I came below, I reached the minimum, the 5 instances, autoscale will try and compensate and provision a new one. Okay, if I look back, like the last 24 hours, I can see that yesterday I put them all to do some work, and you can see that each of those bumps is an eviction. Mm. So somewhere around 2 p.m. yesterday,
yep.
The last VM which did some work got evicted, and then autoscale compensated and created another low priority VM which didn't do any work. So now my VMs do nothing, but I still have 5 low priority VMs.
And you've had 183 different versions of Ziv's VM out there.
Because it's a very simple web server which mm-hmm. does some well, work.
Which brings up an interesting question, though. What kind of work would I want to do? I don't think I want to run my website necessarily on low-priority VMs so if they were important.
Exactly. So whether your application can handle a single VM being kind of evicted, mm-hmm. so that's a key. You need to have these smarts or have your VMs stateless.
Okay.
And then if you want some sort of a minimal guaranteed number of VMs, okay, this brings us to the second use case, which we call hybrid scale set. Hmm. So in this case, we actually combined 2 scale sets. One is an on-demand, fully paid, guaranteed set of instances, and the other is low priority.
Hmm.
2 scale sets behind a single load balancer. You can control both with 2 different autoscaling. You can say, hey, I need minimum 5 VMs, and the rest could be low priority.
That sounds like actually a really nice solution
yep.
because I might have a minimum of 5, I'm going to pay full price, but then I might have another 10 or 15.
Or 100,
yeah, that are all low. Actually, that's interesting because I could have prices 60 or 80% off for the price of 1, I could have 5.
That's exactly the math to keep in mind. Well, if you're using non-Windows.
Using non-Windows.
Yeah. So the way this one looked like, and I called it, believe it or not, hybrid.
Mm-hmm.
And the template, again, we've done this with an ARM template because there are NAT rules and non-default load balancing rules. So first, we're using the standard SLB, not mm-hmm. the basic. So
right.
it's the non-default.
Yep.
You need that because if you want to load balance 2 scale sets, you actually need the standard load balancer.
Makes sense.
Okay. By the way, those could spread multiple availability zones.
Indeed.
As long as it's within the same region. So those are on a single VNet, single subnet. Behind a single load balancer, as I mentioned, and then you can see I have the LP, the low priority scale set, mm-hmm. and the regular scale set. So in this case, the regular, I just set it to 1. So I have 1 guaranteed instance, and the rest may burst. So if I just look at the load balancer this time.
Yep, backend pool, 3 virtual machines.
Yes. So you can see that I have, at this time I have the 1 regular
right.
REG, and just at this time, 2 low priority. Mm-hmm. And again, if I turn on the CPU, turn on the load on those VMs, it will scale first on the low priority,
mm-hmm.
and then eventually, if I fail to scale, on the on-demand.
It really sounds to me like from an application developer's perspective, if I'm thinking about cloud first, if I'm not thinking about old style where all my state's in the VM and my VMs really have to be around for 24 hours a day.
Right.
I'm thinking about using other things, like you said, job schedulers, Azure storage, and keeping my VM stateless. This is hugely valuable.
Yep. One use case we've already tried with customers, if you have any rendering job, then you basically save state in an ongoing way, mm-hmm. fashion, and you just use low priority to burst and finish your job faster.
Mm-hmm.
Azure Batch have been using low priority scale set for quite some time. Actually, they were our guinea pig, so that was the first service using low priority scale set.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm really happy to say that we, based on the confidence we've gained, we decided to let other workloads and other customers to use to benefit from a low priority and discounted
skill sets. So people can certainly look to Azure Batch if their jobs are batch appropriate jobs, but now other people who can just have any virtual machine based job can do this work.
Yep. Before I forget, if you look at your ARM template, there is only one thing to keep in mind. Just bump the API version to anything above December 2017. This is where we started supporting scale set. And then within your virtual machine profile, you see two new properties. One is the priority, which is low if you want low priority, and the eviction policy, which is either delete or the default, which is deallocate.
Mm-hmm. Maybe let's run over to your CLI and see if your VMs got created.
Yep. Actually, we can just go and look for the resource itself.
Yep. And do a refresh.
And there's, I just called it low priority.
Yeah, there it is. Two. Showed up in central use.
And yeah, and by default, it will be a single scale set behind an SLB on a VNet with a public IP. That's a default. No fancy NAT or load balancing rules here.
Sure.
But that's just the basic.
Fantastic.
Yep.
So people can check this out and they can go look at the docs and learn about this?
Yeah. So the doc currently available is the low priority on VM scale sets. It's a preview. The doc has been published a few weeks back. We'll do some more noise as we get closer to a build. There are some known issues with the preview, so I hope by the time this goes out, we will figure out all of those known issues. And just go ahead and try low priority scale sets.
Fantastic. Great way to use that Slack capacity and save a ton of money.
Yep.
All right. I'm learning all about low priority virtual machines and scale sets here on Azure Friday.